faith can never be legitimate if fear or threats are causing it. But moving ahead, I think we can all agree that the most popular aspect of Marian devotion would be its intercession for us. It's very difficult to find a Christian, not only a Catholic, there are other Christians. It's difficult to find a Christian who doesn't accompany his or her prayers to Mary with something else that marks it as Marian devotion, Marian piety. And Marian piety has many forms. Pilgrimages, for example, to Fatima, to Tepeyac in Mexico, where Our Lady and Guadalupe appeared, to Lourdes in France, to Akita in Japan, to Kitebo, I believe it's in Rwanda or Uganda, one of the two. I always get it confused. Marian piety has many forms. As I say, pilgrimages, procession. Father Tony of our community worked many years in Brazil along the Amazon River Valley. And he said that the biggest pilgrimage he knew in his area, which is Belém, it would have been mentioned in our newscast, was on the Feast of Mary, the name of Mary. He estimates that about 1.5 million people are on that pilgrimage. And he tried to go with them, but there were so many people that they were crushing each other, and he's a little guy. So there was problems. He did his best to get out of the crowd and stand in a doorway as the people marched on to pray to Mary, to thank Mary. And he said something very interesting about that pilgrimage. He mentioned that there were carts and trucks with arms, with legs, with parts of the body. They weren't really the arms, legs, they were wax images of people who had been helped by Mary because they had problems with this or that part of their body. And it was a tremendous procession. But it shows the love that people have, our brothers and sisters have. The love we have for Mary. But, since this is my talk, my conference, I have to mention.